ich bin wieder da.
Wo warst du denn so lange?
Mal hier, mal da.
Oh, erzähl mal.
Tut mir leid, heute habe ich keine Zeit.
Schade. Wie wär's mit morgen?
Oh, da kann ich nicht.
Immer bist du beschäftigt.
Ja, da hast du recht.
Du hast nie Zeit für mich.
Ach, hör auf mit diesem Gejammer. Dafür habe ich jetzt echt keinen Nerv.
Oh, ich habe dich aber so vermisst.
Das musst du verstehen. Da ich jetzt so lange weg war, will ich ein paar Videos für YouTube machen.
Du liebst mich nicht mehr.
Hallo alle zusammen. Ich bin wieder da. I am back. And I have a presentation for you about the little word da, because it means so many things in German. Es bedeutet so viele Dinge. Yeah, it can mean here, but it can also mean there. It can refer to time, but it can also refer to place. So we will look at this in this presentation. And this presentation you can also download as a PDF for free. I will put the link in the description. So if you want to download it now, you can pause the video and so you can take some notes, yeah, when I explain you things. Los geht's. So first of all, da has a local meaning in the sense of da sein, to be present. Yeah, sein means to be, right? And da in this case just means present. So first of all, we have ich bin wieder da. It means I am back. Yeah, bin means am. So it's the form of sein here, the conjugated form of sein. And wieder is again, and da means present. So literally, this is kind of like I am again present. Ist Mutti schon da? So again, ist is the form of sein, to be. So and schon is already, da is here or at home. So basically present. So is mom already present? Yeah, is she already here or home? All right. Then ist noch Butter da? Is there any butter left? So literally, is still butter present? For example, how would you say, is there any milk left? Ist noch Milch da? Is there any milk left? Next one, local meaning, there. So, mal hier, mal da. Sometimes here, sometimes there. This is what I said in the introduction. Ah, mal hier, mal da. Deine Jacke ist da hinten. Your jacket is back there. Hinten means in the back. Ja, da hinten, back there. How would you say your pants or your trousers are back there? How would you say that? Deine Hose ist da hinten. Yeah, in German it's Hose, it's singular, because it's one object. In English it's always plural. But in German it's just singular. Deine Hose ist da hinten. Okay? Sind wir schon da? Are we there yet? That's for example a little kid when you're driving somewhere and they keep asking, Mutti, Mutti, sind wir schon da? Are we already there? Okay? Next one, temporal meaning, at that time. So for example, wie wär's mit morgen? So how about tomorrow? This is how we say how about, wie wär's, yeah? Wie wär's mit, with, tomorrow? This is a good chunk to remember, a good phrase. This wie wär's mit, how about something. Da kann ich nicht. So the da is referring to morgen. How about tomorrow? I can't tomorrow. All right? So how would you say, for example, how about the day after tomorrow? How would you say that in German? And then there, I can't. Wie wär's mit übermorgen? We just basically say over tomorrow. This means the day after tomorrow. Wie wär's mit übermorgen? Da kann ich nicht. Oder da kann ich. There, or I can then. Yeah? There I can. Was machst du am Sonntag? Da habe ich Geburtstag. So the da is referring to am Sonntag. What are you doing on Sunday? It's my birthday on Sunday. Okay? And the last one. Er hat mich angerufen, aber da habe ich schon geschlafen. He called me, but I was already asleep by then. Da. So this means at the time he called me, okay? Er hat mich angerufen, aber da, at that time, habe ich schon geschlafen. So, next one. We are not done yet. Wir sind noch nicht fertig. Modal meaning. For example, das ist scheiße. Da hast du recht. This is You're right about that. So something happened and you're like, ah, das ist scheiße. Da hast du recht. So you're referring to whatever that person was talking about. They are right about that. Okay? Next one. Die Deutschen sind ordentlich. Da stimme ich dir zu. Germans are organized. I agree with you on that. Okay? So you're referring to that as well. Last one. Die Deutschen sind pünktlich. Da bin ich ganz anderer Meinung. Germans are punctual. I completely disagree on that. Ganz anderer Meinung. This means totally other opinion or different opinion. Alright. Next one. It can also mean because. Yeah. What is another word you know for because in German? You know this. Weil. Exactly. But you can also use da. Okay? And actually, the word order changes the same way. Let's see. Da ich so lange weg war, because or since, I've been away for so long, will ich morgen ein paar Videos machen. I want to make a few videos tomorrow. You could also say it with weil. Weil ich so lange weg war, yeah, it means really the same thing, will ich morgen ein paar Videos machen. Da es geregnet hat, bin ich zu Hause geblieben. Since or because it was raining, I stayed at home. Zu Hause. I stayed at home. Last one. Ich gehe heute in den Park, da ich frei habe. I'm going to the park today. Yeah, the today is missing. But anyways, because I have a day off. Okay? Again, you can also use weil here. So, frei haben means to have a day off. Ich habe frei. I am free, basically. Yeah, literally. Or I have free. All right, next one. So these are in the da words. I also have a separate video about that. I will link it in the description. Yeah, so dafür habe ich jetzt keinen Nerv. This is what I say in the introduction. Da habe ich jetzt keinen Nerv für. You can also separate this. Yeah, here it's together. Dafür. Here it's separate. Dafür. So, I don't have the nerve for that right now. And really, you can say both versions, yeah? Either separately or together. And the separate one is a bit more colloquial. Yeah, when you say da and then für at the end, it's a bit more colloquial. Next one. Da habe ich keine Lust zu. It's the same. You can put it separate or together. Dazu habe ich keine Lust. I am not in the mood for that. Lust in German is just to be in the mood for something, yeah? It's not sexual, it's not like lust, okay? Ich habe keine Lust, Deutsch zu lernen. I don't feel like learning German. Oder ich habe Lust, Deutsch zu lernen. I feel like learning German. Da träume ich seit Jahren von. Davon träume ich seit Jahren. I've been dreaming about that for years, yeah? Davon. And with these da words, it's important that you know the prepositions, yeah? For example, here it's always Lust zu etwas haben, yeah? Ich habe Lust zu. Here it's ich träume von, I dream about, yeah? The prepositions are important. And then the first one is ich habe keinen Nerv dafür, yeah? Für etwas einen Nerv haben. So to have a nerve for something. It's the same as in English, but the other ones are different in English. Then we have a filler word. So, da haben wir ein Problem. You're thinking about that something bad can happen and then you say, oh, da haben wir ein Problem. Wenn das passiert, da haben wir ein Problem. If that happens, then we have a problem. Okay? There we have a problem. Or, da haben wir den Salat in the same kind of meaning. There we have the salad. What does this mean? Do you know? To have the salad, yeah? Oh, da haben wir den Salat. It's actually kind of the same thing. Da haben wir ein Problem, yeah? It means like we're in a fine mess now. The fat in the fire. Oh, I like that. Or the fat has hit the fan or something. Isn't there a saying like that in English? Anyways, it means like something bad happened, okay? And the last one, da haben wir Glück gehabt. Oh, we were lucky there. With whatever has happened, you're referring to that and we were lucky, yeah? Da haben wir Glück gehabt. Wow, viele Bedeutungen, lots of meanings. Now, a typical mistake. Let's see if you know, yeah? Let's see if you get it right. Wo ist der Supermarkt? Er ist, where's the supermarket? It's there. How would you say this? Wo ist der Supermarkt? Er ist da, yeah? Simple. You can just say it's there. Er ist da. Or er ist da hinten. It's back there. Oder er ist da drüben. Yeah? Da drüben is like over there. You can also use dort. Er ist dort. Oder dort hinten. Oder dort drüben. Yeah? Same thing. Same thing. Now, jetzt. Mal sehen. Let's see. An der Ecke ist ein Supermarkt. In the corner, there is a supermarket. Or at the corner, on the corner. I don't know what it is in English, whatever. An der Ecke, we say in German. Ich gehe, I am going there. Ich gehe dahin. This is the typical mistake. Here you need a hin because it's indicating that you're changing position. You're going to somewhere. So in English, you could also say, it sounds weird, but I'm going to there, yeah? It's the same in the question if you're asking somebody, where are you going to? So you would say in German, wohin gehst du? Okay, oder wo gehst du hin? You can also put the hin in the end. But you need the hin to indicate that you're going from one place to another, okay? And here it's the same thing. Ich gehe dahin. Or with dort, what would it be? What do you think? Ich gehe dorthin. Okay? That's the typical mistake because lots of foreigners, they will just say ich gehe da oder ich gehe dort. And a native speaker will hear it because we are like, oh, there is something missing. Like, something is missing. Something is wrong. Oh my God. Nein, 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 nein. If you want to download this PDF, the link is in the description. It's for free. So I hope you enjoyed this video and see you soon. Bis bald. Tschüss.